Professional Guild and the Pet Professional Accreditation Board, two companies, one shared guiding principle. The goal of this presentation is to introduce you to PPG and PPAB, so you have a clear understanding about who are we, how we believe competence is mission critical, how we want to accomplish competence, the accountability factors, and then putting it all together. PPG is a 501c6 non-profit and was founded based on a commitment to provide educational resources to pet care providers and the public, coupled with an emphasis on building collaboration amongst force-free pet professionals. PPG partners, members and affiliates focus on each pet's physical, mental, environmental and nutritional well-being. Established at the beginning of 2012, PPG began with a very simple goal of servicing the pet industry. It was our idea to be an educational antidote to the scientifically unfounded and dangerous methods and practices popularized by entertainment television. There was a frustration by the lack of comprehensive resources committed to force-free training and pet care based on current scientific learning theory. We believed the pet industry needed a source of information where pet owners and pet professionals who are committed to force-free training and pet care methods could share ideas, exchange best practices, continue our education, collaborate on efforts, and find resources that are truly force-free based. In addition, it was felt that the pet-owning public needed an educational resource that would clarify the differences in training and pet care methodologies, and where a pet owner could be confident that the information, services and products offered were on the forefront of force-free training and pet care. First, PPG believes that our profession of animal training, behavior and pet care stands on a tripod of art, science and relationships, each as important as the other. Everything we do needs to be underpinned in science, applied with creative artistic endeavors and delivered through the development of mutually respectful caring relationships. We have a serious responsibility and obligation to advocate for those who cannot advocate for themselves. All our interactions with our clients needs to be mutually beneficial to all, and interactions with our industry stakeholders needs to be beneficial to the future welfare of our pets. Who are we? PPG has numerous member products: Barks from the Guild, News from the Guild, Blogs by the Guild, Pet Dog Ambassador Program, and then our individual charters: PPG British Isles, PPG Australia, and then PPG Singapore. Barks from the Guild is published 6 times per year and managed by Susan Nilsson. Barks represents a collection of valuable business and technical articles, as well as reviews and news stories pertinent to our industry. Barks is the official publication of the Pet Professional Guild and is distributed free to all members. PPG also has a pet owner member category. Pet owners can join for free. It's our belief that if we can educate pet owners, then they will begin to demand from our industry transparency and accountability. PPG World Service is broadcast live each month and features a selection of interviews, product reviews, and educational material. The PPG's guiding principles. PPG is the only association that has a clear and unambiguous guideline on training and pet care practices. The first section of our PPG guiding principles are our non-negotiables. Pet Professional Guild members understand force-free to mean no shock, no pain, no choke, no fear, no physical force, no compulsion-based methods are employed to train or care for a pet. So what is the definition of force? Any definition can never be so expansive and explicit that every possible situation is addressed. This is seen everywhere in life, and most obviously in the US legal system, where very often courts cannot agree on a single interpretation of what terms and definitions mean, including force-free. Recognizing this, we understand in the context of our guiding principles and as a general framework, physical force to mean any intentional physical act against a pet that causes psychological or physical pain, harm, or damage. Our philosophy on equipment use is that some equipment is covered in our non-negotiables, and it's just that, non-negotiable. But what about other equipment use? Clearly the use of many, most, harnesses, head halters and collars that are non-choking and leashes would not be considered physical force under the guiding definition if 1. They are used consistently with our guiding principles, 2. They are used as intended and designed, and 3. They are not used in a way that is contrary to their design and intent. So that means they're not used in a manner which would cause psychological or physical pain, harm or damage. In 2015, PPG opened up a separate company called the Pet Professional Accreditation Board. The goal in creating PPAB was to establish a respected professional credential that demonstrates not only academic accomplishments and real-world expertise, but also reflects commitment to a consistent philosophy and ethic. To accomplish this goal and to ensure the quality and integrity of the program, PPAB partnered with a leading independent job skills assessment company, Nocte Business Solutions. Over the course of 18 months, the exam and exam process were developed in accordance with strict professional testing protocols. The first objective undertaken by PPG was to develop a job task analysis. Created by subject matter experts, the JTA establishes what should be known versus what is nice to know. Questions with specific scientific and professional citations were then developed correlating directly back to the JTA. Once created, the questions were assembled into a pilot examination. In addition to developing the JTA, it is critical that any testing process meets certain criteria to ensure its long-term viability. There are 4 qualities present in meaningful professional examinations: reliability, standardization, validity and practicality. Of these 4, the most important to ensure the efficacy of a professional examination are reliability and validity. So how do we accomplish competence? The pathway to accreditation is robust and tests both academic knowledge and mechanical competency. And for the PCBCA, the Professional Canine Behaviour Consultant, it also tests a selection of case studies. For each credential, there is an eligibility requirement, some form of examination that tests academic theory, and then a video assessment process that looks at mechanical competency. There's also some exciting news. We're currently working on a 3rd credentialing level, a technician level, that will be available by June 2016. You do not have to be a PPG active member to apply and become credentialed through the PPAB. You do, however, have to meet and maintain the eligibility criteria. The Pet Professional Accreditation Program is independent of any industry school, trade school, college, or credentialing body. Applicants who pass the requirements earn specific titles which may be used after their names. There are currently 2 programs, an accreditation for professional canine trainers and an accreditation for canine behavior consultants. Each program has a rigorous path to completion. The eligibility requirements are: all applicants must agree to PPAB's guiding principles, must be over the age of 21, must be able to demonstrate 300 hours experience of group training classes and or 150 hours of private training. Applicants must either be full-time or part-time professionals. Applicants must provide proof of business insurance. Applicants must have completed 30 continuing education credits at professional seminars, workshops, and/or webinars during the last 3 years. Applicants must have a professional up-to-date website or Facebook page. And there is also a renewal eligibility which occurs every 24 months. To take the proctored examination, applicants must also have a government-issued photo ID. As soon as the candidate passes the necessary gatekeeper requirement for eligibility, then they're approved to take the exam. The examination contains 250 multiple-choice questions that have been carefully selected across several key subject areas: learning and behavior, biology and anatomy, ethology, canine communication and social behavior, health and development, business skills, consulting skills and best practice, and scientific and practical method. The pass score for the exam is 77.6%. On successful completion of the examination, candidates are then invited to submit their training videos. One of these training videos is also demonstrating teaching the dog a simple trick, and there's a coaching video requirement too. Mechanical expectations and competency. 100% compliance is expected. All training methods must be force-free. Trainers must make allowances for behavioral signals and issues and take into account a dog's breed and age. The trainer is assessed on how they handle any untoward behavioral issue that arises and how they ensure the training environment is conducive to optimal learning for the dog. The case studies. Because PPAB has worked closely with psychometric testing experts to standardize the credentialing process, there is a very strict format for case studies. Applicants must adhere to this required format with precision and present their case studies exactly as directed. This ensures that test reviewers can assess objectively whether each case study meets the requisite standard or not. And when necessary, this standardization also enables PPAB to give applicants accurate feedback about why they may not have met a specific standard. PPAB's accreditation program also has the necessary process in place to handle official ethics complaints. The key role of the ethics committee is to investigate all reported ethics violations in a professional, competent, and confidential manner. So putting it all together, PPG and PPAB, an organization who has a strict set of guiding principles, an organization who believes force-free requires a high level of competence, and the only organization that has a strict application and membership criteria. In any professional field, competency is considered the most ethical obligation a professional has. Competency is typically defined as having professional knowledge. It demands that professionals have been schooled in the theory and research of their industry, and as a result, hold the necessary skills to apply that field of knowledge to a working situation with their clients. It's also imperative, however, for us to understand that competence is the measure of actual professional performance, and not the level and amount of education one has received. High levels of education do not guarantee competency, and conversely, a professional lacking a high level of education does not correlate to a lack of competency. It is the goal of PPG and PPAB to develop a highly skilled force of competent force-free professionals that clients, peers, and the veterinary community can rely on. The input and output factors to this process are already in place. The input is an association of committed, force-free professionals, and the output measure is the credentialing process. The actual process is now being developed, and this will be a series of modules developed by third-party professionals and based on the requirement components of the PPAB study guide. These modules will be in place by October 2016. In closing, we can and will bring about change in our industry. At PPG and PPAB, we believe in ourselves and our organization and its underpinning principles and values. We believe we can and will bring about change in the pet industry. We will continue to engage and educate industry professionals. We will continue to communicate in an impactful manner so we can collaborate and influence others. We will endeavor to balance emotional appeals with facts and solid reasoning, and will always use data and logic. As an organization, we will be respectful and courteous in all of our communication, so we maintain positive dialogue. This is how we will continue to spread our message to audiences that are receptive to listening. And my last request to all of us is that we all aspire to bring about what we believe in. Be force-free in our own behavior and communication. Let the results of force-free training and pet care speak for themselves. We're building a community of professionals to help us move our mission forwards. For any questions on the Pet Professional Guild or the Pet Professional Accreditation Board, please visit our websites, petprofessionalguild.com, credentialingboard.com. Stand up for what you believe in. Become accredited today.